I'm heading where?
You're in here.
Oh, lovely.
Hello, Nicol.
Oh my God.
Hello.
Oh my God.
Oh, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Hello,
it's
Killian.
Incredible. Hi, James.
Yeah, it's great to meet you. Great to meet you. Yeah.
An experience.
I'm glad you're at least as tall as me.
Inside a Mini.
Wow. And the reason we're here is that we like miniaturization of things, whether it's electric motors or products, you know, making things smaller. And it was a wonderful example of miniaturization that you and I can sit in this tiny thing with a motor
there
and three adults on the back and our luggage in the boot. The kind of thing I've tried to do with this, which is our latest vacuum cleaner. So this is the pencil vac.
Was so mind-blowing when you only hold the tube. No way, there's the whole vacuum of a tube.
But this is the inspiration, so it's why we're here.
It's the whole thing.
That's the whole thing.
I swear, I was about to ask, where's the machine on top?
No, this is it. So hence why the Mini has always been such inspiration for me.
And that's why it's called the pencil bag. It's like a pencil.
It's like a pencil, yeah. And the new hush jet.
Oh, wow.
Looks like a jet turbine.
Well, it eats it away. All these shapes are critical. They look sort of as though it's a fancy design, but actually they're all critical for the airflow and the noise. And the one I think you've seen, which is the robot, it's washing the floor, but it's also checking that it's cleaned all the spots.
Right.
So if it sees that it's gone over it, but it hasn't got rid of it, it turns around, does it again, checks it. If it hasn't got rid of it, turns around, does it again. It'll do that 15 times. I think we're solving one of the major problems of wet robots.